Hey, what is going on, guys? RVZ Stealth here, and in today's video, we're gonna be taking a look at why this new Glacial Augment, Twin Shadows, and Hextech GLP setup is really good right now, and then 8 champions that can work great with this setup. So if I'm not mistaken, this setup originally started over in Korea, where a master tier Vel'Koz player was running this setup for a while, and then eventually other players started to catch on to this build. I've been running it myself for the past few months on Vel'Koz, and then some pro players started to pick it up as well. We saw Bjergsen play it on Vel'Koz in the LCS, and he had some pretty good success with it. And then since then, there have been other champions or other players have decided to try this setup out on other champions, and they are having some really good success with it. So the main reason to why this setup works really well is due to the synergy between Glacial Augment, Twin Shadows, and Hextech GLP. Whenever you shoot out the active portion of your Twin Shadows or your Hextech GLP and it hits an enemy, your Glacial Augment is going to shoot out a freeze ray that's going to slow the enemies for 5 seconds, and it's going to be a 60% slow. So this just gives you a ton of extra utility for the champion that you're playing, and it just gives yourself a lot of kiting potential, a lot of pick potential, and it just is really, really strong for team fights. Now, not only does it help you kite really well and it helps you lock down the enemies, it also helps you very easily line up your abilities and hit your skill shots. A lot of the champions that are doing very well with this setup do have skill shot abilities in their kit, and most of their abilities in their kits are skill shots. So by landing this slow, it's almost guaranteed that you're going to be able to line up and hit your skill shots, which is just going to provide you with a lot of consistent damage there due to this setup. A few other reasons to why this setup works really well is because you do spike a lot earlier on into the game with this build path. Your build path of Twin Shadows and your Hextech GLP is going to cost you 5.2k gold, whereas a regular build path of a Luden's Echo into Morello is going to cost you 6.2k, so it's 1,000 gold less for this build setup, and it is going to give you a very nice mid-game spike. If you do decide to go for Lucidity Boots as your boots of choice, then you can also reach 40% CDR super early on into the game. Once you get your Twin Shadows, your GLP, and your Lucidity Boots, you will be at 40% CDR. So this is really good for mid lane champions, because reaching that 40% CDR is very important a lot of the time, and you can do that very fast with this setup. This setup also works really well because you can take the Biscuit Delivery along with Time Warp Tonic and Corrupting Potion, and then you can grab a Dark Seal early on into the game, and your sustain with this setup is really, really good. You're just gonna have a ton of sustain in the early to mid game, which is gonna help you out a lot, and you're almost always gonna be topped up on HP and mana in the early game. Now for the rune setup here, the things that are interchangeable are going to be your magical footwear for your stopwatch. You can switch those out depending on if the enemy team does have a lot of dive or kill threat in the early game. You can swap your biscuit delivery for the dematerializer if you feel like the enemy doesn't have a ton of poke in the laning phase. If you're not going to be getting chunked out and you don't need that added sustain, then you can run the dematerializer. Time Warp Tonic there, you're going to want to run that pretty much every game if you are going for the corrupting potion start. And then as for your secondary runes here, the Ingenious Hunter, run this every single game. You're going to want that to have the lower cooldown on your GLP and your Twin Shadows actives. And then for your other rune there, either go Cheap Shot or Taste of Blood. Both are really good. If you feel like you have some kill pressure in the laning phase, if you don't want the added sustain, then run Cheap Shot. But if you do want some more sustain, then run your Taste of Blood. And then for your build setup here, obviously Twin Shadows into your Hextech GLP is going to be your core build. For boots, you can either go Sork Boots or Lucidity Boots. Most players do go Lucidity Boots with this setup because it is going to give you the 40% CDR there. You can go for Sork Boots if you're snowballing really hard in the early game. It does come down to personal preference and the situation. And then for your items after Twin Shadows and GLP, a lot of it does come down to the game and the situation that you're in. If you just want more damage and you're snowballing really hard in the early game, then go Rabadon's third item. If you want more survivability, then go Zhonya's. If the enemy team does have a lot of healing, then go Morello's. You just gotta kind of weigh out the situation and decide which item is gonna be best. So now let's take a look at which champions work best with this setup. First off, we're gonna go over the S tier champions. So the champions that you should be running this setup on pretty much every single game, and it is their best setup. And then after that, we'll take a look at the A tier champions. So champions that can run the setup, but it's not necessarily the best, and there is other options that do work better most of the time. So for the S tier champions here, we have Veigar, Ahri, Vel'Koz, and Talia. So for Veigar, this setup is just great on him because Veigar doesn't really need the extra damage from other runes. Veigar's main weakness is the fact that he is going to be easily just picked off, and he doesn't have any mobility in his kit, so any extra ability to kite and just peel for himself is going to help him out a lot there. So by running this setup, it just gives him added utility that is really nice, and you just don't need the extra damage with other items and with the other runes, so this is just a great build for Veigar. So for Ahri, the setup works really well because it almost guarantees that you're going to be able to hit your charm if you do proc the slow from your Glacial Augment. It's just such a big slow, it's going to last for such a long time, so a lot of the time you're going to be able to line up that charm and hit it, and if you can hit your charm consistently with Ahri, then you are going to have a ton of success with her. It also does give her some really nice catch potential in the early to mid game. If she is ahead, then she can look to just throw out her Twin Shadows. If it does hit the enemy, then she can look to dive in and look for the assassination. And then for Talia, it's great on her for some of the same reasons as Ahri. It does give yourself a much higher chance of landing one of your main damage abilities and one of your main pick abilities in your W, and if you can consistently hit your W with Talia, then you are going to have very good chances of winning on this champion. It also does give you some really nice kiting potential there in the mid game. Talia is an immobile champion, so just getting the active slows there with the GLP and with the Twin Shadows just gives you some really nice kiting potential for the mid game. And then for Vel'Koz, this champion, every single one of his abilities is a skill shot, so by running this setup, it almost guarantees that you're going to be able to hit your skill shots consistently on the champion, and as long as you can hit your skill shots on Vel'Koz with your passive, with your true damage there, and just with your low cooldown abilities, you are going to deal a ton of damage with this setup. And then four other mid laners that you can try this out on, and it can be pretty good for them, but it's not necessarily the best, are Aurelion Sol, Heimerdinger, Brand, and Zilean. So for Aurelion Sol, Phase Rush is still really good on him. Most players are still running Phase Rush right now. Glacial Augment was run on Aurelion Sol in the past, and it's not a bad option on him, but Phase Rush is still pretty superior to the Glacial Augment, but you can definitely try it out, and it's not a terrible option on him. For Heimerdinger, it gives yourself some really nice pick potential in the mid game because when you do throw out your Twin Shadows, and if it does hit the enemy, it's going to be a lot easier for you to line up that Alt E, or in a team fight, if you throw out your Twin Shadows and throw out your GLP and the enemies are just grouped up and they're slowed for that 60%, then landing that Alt E in a team fight is going to be much easier, and it can be really game changing if you can hit that when the enemies are slowed. It's also going to help you out in team fights because if the enemies are slowed inside your turrets, then your turrets are going to be dealing a ton of damage to them, and it's just overall a pretty good option for Heimerdinger. For Brand there, it's pretty good on him because Brand, along with a lot of these other champions, is a very vulnerable champion, and he doesn't have a ton of utility in his kit other than his stun, which isn't really a reliable peeling ability for himself, so it does give him some nice utility there for the mid game. It does keep him a little bit safer, and if you do proc the massive slow there in a team fight and the enemies are grouped up, then the chances of you hitting like a multi-man ultimate or a multi-man W and just getting a ton of AoE damage off in a team fight is going to go up by a lot. And then for Zilean, because he's a pick that doesn't have a ton of kill pressure in the laning phase, and because he's mainly picked to just support his team and be a utility champion anyways, he can do well with the Glacial Augment because he is going to provide his team with a lot of utility there for the mid game. It's also great for him because his double bomb combo becomes a lot easier to hit, and your double bomb combo on Zilean is just such a game changing combo if you can hit it consistently. So when you do throw your slows in team fight, your chance of hitting that double bomb combo goes up by a ton, and it is going to give you a lot more CC and presence in mid game fights. So that is going to be all for this video, guys. Those were 8 mid lane champions that do have a really good synergy with this Glacial Augment setup. If you have yet to try this setup out on any of these champions and you are a mid lane player, then I would definitely recommend it. It is a pretty fun setup and it is actually really strong on these champions. So with that being said, guys, if you did enjoy this video, then be sure to leave a like and subscribe if you have yet to already. So thanks for watching, have an awesome day, and I'll see you in my next video.